Subscribe to our channel and click on the bell button to receive important financial updates faster than anybody else. In this video, we'll be talking about an entity where the promoters have recently acquired 75 lakh units at rupees 75.6, and the entity at this particular price provides a dividend yield of a whopping 16%, which probably may be one of the highest in the markets. Please watch this video to know more. Now, the entity in question is IRB Infrastructure Investment Trust, and this is available currently at rupees 75.84. the face value for it is 98.30, and the symbol for it is IRB INVIT. Now, promoters of IRB Infrastructure Developers have been accumulating IRB INVIT from the open market. While investors have remained on the sidelines, promoters seem to have found value as units hit a 52-week low of rupees 75. The fund is currently offering a yield of close to 16% based on the guided dividend per unit of 12.3 for FY19. The effective yield could in fact turn out to be higher, considering that only a few months are remaining before FY19 ends. The promoters of IRB Infrastructure Developers recently bought 75 lakh units at a price of rupees 75.6. In May 2017, IRB Infra offloaded part of its road assets through an infrastructure investment trust at Rs. 102 a share, which is estimated to provide a yield of close to 12%. Despite the high yield, investor interest was waning and units hit a low. IRB Infra is not alone. IndiGrid InvIT, sponsored by Sterlite Power Grid Ventures, is trading at Rs. 92.2 as against its issue price of Rs. 100 a unit. Based on the guided payout of Rs. 12 per unit for FY19, IndiGrid's yield works out to be 13%. Now, IndiGrid has been performing relatively better in terms of unit price because transmission and distribution assets are being perceived as less risky and volatile in terms of cash flows. Factors like GST and demonetization had hit the cash flow of road developers. Now, IRB InvIT is holding 7 operational road assets, most of which are well placed in terms of commanding a locational advantage. Most of these assets have seen strong traction in traffic after the initial hiccups led by GST and other issues. Moreover, they have raised applicable tolls in line with inflation. During Q1 FY19, these projects generated revenue of Rs. 302 crores and net distributable cash flows of Rs. 193 crores. This works to about 772 crores on an annualized basis, or 17% of its market capitalization. During Q1 FY18, it paid out Rs. 3.05 per unit as dividend. Even if we deduct the same from the dividend that it is planning to pay out in the current fiscal, the yield works out to be over 12% for the remainder of the fiscal. Now, while estimating current year's dividend of Rs. 12.3 per unit, the management had factored in a traffic growth of 5.5% and wholesale inflation at 4.5%, which could be on the conservative side. Positive changes such as higher traffic growth and inflation would mean higher growth in distributable cash and a better yield, which the market may not be anticipating at current prices. The entity presents a very attractive investment venture at the current market price. Now, friends, please don't consider this to be a recommendation on our part. Please go ahead and do your own research. This and all other content that you see on our channel is intended to be a piece of news. Thanks for watching, and if you have not yet subscribed to this channel, please consider doing so.